sogno l'orizzonte e mancano le parole. Sì, lo so che non c'è luce in una stanza quando manca il sole. Se non ci sei tu,
so thanks for talking to us today. I'm just curious, can you tell us, April, or tell us a little background about the story of your client?
Sure. Little old gentleman, he's about 73, 74. He had spent his life here in Vegas working in the culinary industry and was single, no children, didn't have any family in town. The facility he was in approached us about doing a guardianship for him because he was having some issues managing. So we agreed to do that, and I became the guardian. Soon after that, the facility started having some issues with his pet, his little dog, named Mr. Albert, and he loves this dog. The dog's his whole life, and it's his only life that he has. The facility continued to raise his rates, and
so, April, can you tell us a little bit more about how they isolated Mr. Doe at the previous location or the facility?
Yeah, they required that he take his meals in his room because of the animal. The dog would bark when he was away from him. And so it became quite an expense because there's a meal, a tray cost for every meal. And he just wasn't having the socialization that he needs to flourish in a community. And it was sad for him. He was very nervous, he was very distressed, and he had all that time to sit alone and just work this all through his brain.
So with all these problems that were going on at the facility and all the phone calls from Mr. Doe, what did you do about it?
Well, I started looking around at different facilities. I wanted to see if we couldn't do something to make him happy since this little dog was such a big part of his life. So made some inquiries and found a facility that was very pet friendly. Room and Prestige was wonderful in putting this together for him. We had some issues at the other facility with my ward not being able to get the dog outside in a timely manner, and so we had some accidents. But Jean did an excellent job doing this. They put in a doggy door, they put a little fence around the patio, which is much bigger and more wonderful than I expected. It's gated. It's wonderful. You need to come see.
Let's go take a look.
Okay.
So there's a little dog door for him.
There's a dog door. And my maintenance employees came out here and they made a huge
dog
run for him, and he's got enough space here.
Right. Have fun. And I have a little table and chair coming for him so that he can sit out here and enjoy the fresh air with Mr. Albert.
Right to choose how and where you
done a great job about making a good fit for you and Mr. Albert.
Yes.
A match for all around.
You can see that. And you know it in the dog's life. The dog's life is just as important to me as the human life.
There's
Candy. There's
your
other dog.
Is that his girlfriend?
No, that's one of the
that's Bobby's dog.
People that are here have that little dog.
That's Bobby's dog.
I'm also a registered nurse, and I worked in an ICU, and we actually did studies that if we brought a pet in, a cat or a dog particularly, the respiratory rate calmed down, the heart rate calmed down, the resident was, or the patient was much calmer. We see that here also. They're calmer when they have that dog in their lap.
One of the things that we stress, and it may seem somewhat awkward to children that we don't think about how important it is to our parents to be able to interact with their animals. And I don't just say that as an attorney, but I also say that because I have firsthand experience. And I just had a situation where literally last night, my 94-year-old grandmother is relocating from Philadelphia here in Las Vegas, and she's got some serious health problems. And this morning at about 5:30 in the morning, I heard her up. She was having some problems breathing. I went to her room to go check on her, make sure she was okay, and I thought I heard her talking to herself, and what I hadn't realized is my daughter's ferret had made it down out of his cage, down the stairs, into her bedroom, and I didn't say a word, but I was able to watch the way she interacted with the animal. She picked him up, he's about 18 inches long, she cuddled him, she held him, she stroked him. And quite frankly, she was able to control her breathing. It calmed her down. The soothing effect on her was just absolutely amazing. Mm-hmm. And to watch that for 5 minutes, the way they interacted, it just confirms for me how important it is that children and grandchildren don't take that for granted, what their loved ones miss when they don't get that interaction with their animals. It makes a huge difference.
So April, with this real positive win story, can you give us some suggestions for the rest of Las Vegas and Nevada and beyond? So what do you see we as a community could do to make more of these success stories happen?
I think that these facilities need to remember that it's about the client, it's about the resident. That just because they're old and maybe because they are demented, that they still have needs. They have needs for love and affection. They have needs to be with other people as well as interact with animals, interact with whether they're pet therapy groups or their own animals or their pets that maybe they've had to leave with someone else. I'm very pro clients or patient rights. I just feel like sometimes they get so caught up in the corporate rules and regs that they forget that they're dealing with people.